My name is Lisa, and I'm going to talk about Nestov Art Museum. It was opened in 1920s, and it was named after Mikhail Nestov, a Russian artist and native. Let's talk about its history. In 1913, Mikhail Nestov presented Ufa a great collection of works by Russian artists of 19th and 20th centuries, as well as about 30 paintings of his own. This collection included works of such famous artists like Ivan Shishkin, Isaac Levitan, Konstantin Korovin, and many others. The exposition was supposed to be placed in Aksaka People's House, but its construction was delayed due to events of World War I and revolutions of 1917. So therefore, until 1919, the Nestov Assembly was kept in Moscow. After the liberation of Ufa from Kolchak's troops in 1919, the Revolutionary Committee established the foundation of October Revolution Artistic Museum in Ufa. Aksaka People Houses was not completed yet, so the house of timber merchant Vaktiv was allocated for this museum.
As for the museum's collections, it includes unique works by the father of Russian futurism, David Burlyuk. In terms of quantity and quality, this is the largest collection of Burlyuk's works in Russia. The museum also has a collection of engravings of the 15th and 19th centuries, representing famous schools of engraving of Great Britain, Germany, Holland, France, works of sculpture of the 18th and 19th centuries by Danish, Italian, and French artists. If you are into the culture of Bashkir people, be sure to see the exhibition of fine and decorative arts of Bashkortostan. Unique examples of weaving, embroidery, wood carving, jewelry and costume of Bashkir people, painting, graphics, sculpture and ceramics. The total number of items in the museum's collection is more than 12,000. In conclusion, I wanted to mention that if you are fond of arts, you can buy some books on this theme there. Also, there are a lot of different souvenirs you can buy, for example, cards and cups with famous paintings and so on.